host and hypnotherapist. Welcome to Santa Barbara Hypnotized, co-creating mind, body, and spirit in paradise. Have you ever wondered about hypnosis? Maybe you even have a challenge and have considered the possibility that hypnotherapy is a solution. But like most, have preconceived notions brought on by freaky 1950s movies, sci-fi sound effects, hypnotic swirls, mind control, and other media sensationalized rumors. It's not entertainment, nor is it magic. But I have to admit, it does make for a great plot. Unfortunately, hypnosis is much less dramatic than it's been played out. Hypnosis is, simply put, your brain relaxing into the slower brain waves that we naturally slip into at least twice a day. Our brains are actually wired to go into hypnosis for our sleep transition. And we do this just before we fall asleep at night and right before we awake in the morning. Can you recall that feeling right before you fall asleep? That in-between states, not fully awake, wondering if you're asleep or awake? That moment is a state of hypnosis. Let me ask you too, have you gotten so wrapped up in a show that you have even cried or have gotten fearful? How about lost in a book? Even though you're simply reading a two-dimensional black and white piece of paper, you get entranced by the words and you feel what the characters feel. Just as if you're right there in that moment. Emotions evoked, right? How about this one? Have you been driving in your car and missed your exit because you were in a trance? Or suddenly driven several miles and don't remember having driven there? How about tuning out while someone was talking to you and who knows where your mind went? Or when you fall in love and you're completely suggestible to that other special person? These are all great examples of everyday hypnosis, and all are normal. As a matter of fact, can you recall how it felt for your brain waves to lower, getting slower? I love that our brain has a simple tool. Ready to try? It's just a few seconds, okay? So you're just gonna take a deep breath in, close your eyes, and that's it. So come on, ready? All right, just try it. Breathe in, close your eyes, and just pay attention to that simple relaxation you feel while slowly releasing your breath. Good. Now if you want, you can leave your eyes closed for a few seconds longer. And if you practice this very basic thing, it actually strengthens the muscle memory to relax anytime. Anytime you need to take just a brief moment to just breathe and close your eyes. Okay, one more time, just because it felt so good. Breathe in, close your eyes. Can you feel the calmness just a little more the second time? That was a very basic feeling of hypnosis. So with that being said, everyone is hypnotizable, some just more than others. You may feel good and relaxed, perhaps on the verge of sleep while going into hypnosis. Or on the other spectrum, you might be saying to yourself, oh, this isn't working. I'm not feeling it. But the more you think you are not, the more you are actually going deeper into hypnosis. And you could actually fall from one extreme to the other. But most actually just fall somewhere right here in between. And there are a few things that can affect hypnosis, such as contact lenses, which can irritate the eyes, and any alcohol or drugs, including medications. These can all affect your level of hypnosis. If you've previously watched one of my shows, or been hypnotized before, you know what hypnosis is. For those that have not, I want to let you know some of the things to expect. First is that you will be present at all times, hearing everything I say, and you'll know that you can just get up and walk around the room anytime you'd like, but you won't want to. You'll be just too relaxed. Now, I obviously have no magical powers, and you won't be made to do or say anything that you don't want to. And there's no way to get stuck in hypnosis because our brains, like I mentioned before, is wired for this hypnotic state. Hypnosis just makes you hypersuggestible. It's a deep state of relaxation. And in our sessions, in our show sessions, I'll actually use the word deep sleep, but you won't fall asleep or be unconscious. This is just a gentle reminder to let go and just into that sleep-like feeling. In your deep relaxation, you may feel light, tingling sensations, or you may feel heavy, relaxed feelings of comfort. You may just feel like you've slept 8 hours. Yet, you maybe will have no sensation at all, just a simple feeling of relaxation and calmness with your eyes closed. Now, you may also at first find yourself with distracting thoughts, and this is normal. This is just your mind sorting and integrating with your subconscious. It's our subconscious that drives us. So in hypnosis, a relaxed state, we will be talking to your subconscious to make this shift and co-create your success for change. If you're interested in learning more, please watch my show on the theory of mind to understand the subconscious's role in our daily lives. Now, we already know that hypnosis is an excellent tool for helping people. And one of the benefits of hypnosis is that we can access and work with your subconscious to facilitate change. So, we're going to hypnotize you and access your subconscious and begin the therapeutic process. For most people, when they wake up after their first hypnosis in therapy, describe how much better and relaxed they feel and can see how the process of changing a habit, overcoming challenges, and or mastering self-improvement has already begun. And I look really forward to that. Unfortunately, at the end, I will have to count you up and out of your relaxation. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you will be back to your awake state, wide awake, refreshed and alert. Thank you for watching. I hope you've been motivated to watch what Santa Barbara Hypnotized has in store for you. Together, let's rewrite the current views on hypnosis. Watch and interact with these therapeutic sessions. From my heart to yours. I'm Tara Lilly, and this has been Santa Barbara Hypnotized. See you soon.